In this video, we'll provide an overview of Gigya's registration as a service as it relates to site groups. As mentioned in the RaaS fundamentals video, the three primary components of RaaS are the screen sets, site policies, and database schema. Each of these components plays an important role in a successful RaaS implementation. This video will focus on how each of these three components are configured and integrated together with Gigya's site grouping functionality. Site grouping is the process of grouping multiple child sites together under a parent API key so that they share a common database of users. As such, when we integrate RaaS with site groups, it's important to remember that there is only one database of users shared among the entire site group. When using RaaS with site grouping, the site policy should be configured on the parent API key and will automatically be inherited by the child API keys. This means that all API keys within a site group share the same set of RaaS policies. Here's a screenshot of what the site policies tab looks like within the admin console on the child API key. Notice that most of the settings are grayed out and cannot be edited here. Instead, there is a note that tells you which parent site the policies were derived from. As such, within the admin console, you will only be able to edit the RaaS policies for a site group at the parent API key level. The only exception to this rule is that email templates and basic plugin settings can be overridden by child API keys, either through the admin console or through an accounts.setPolicies call to the child API key. As we mentioned earlier, the core concept behind site grouping is to provide the ability to store users across multiple sites within a single consolidated database. This means that when RaaS is used in a site group, all API keys within the group will share the same database schema, as there is in fact only one database of users. An important concept to remember is that since the schema is shared across all API keys within the site group, setting a field to required on any API key within the site group will cause it to be required on all API keys in the site group. It is possible to make changes to your database schema by making an accounts.setSchemaAPI call using the parent or any child API key in the site group, which will modify the database schema for the entire site group. With regard to the RaaS screen sets, there is often a need to load a different set of registration and login screens to meet the branding requirements of each website in your site group. However, please keep in mind that all screen sets must include the same set of required fields. These screen sets can be managed on the parent API key of your site group in the Gigya admin console. You will then be able to load any screen set that is defined on the parent API key on any of your child sites in the site group. This table compiles the important information that we have discussed regarding integrating RaaS with site grouping. As site grouping is based off a single database of users, there is only one set of site policies and only one database schema that applies to the entire site group. It is very important to keep in mind that any changes to the database schema made using the accounts.setSchemaAPI call will apply to the entire site group, regardless of whether the call was made using a parent or child API key. Also remember that you will only be able to configure RaaS screen sets on the parent API key. Child sites inherit all screen sets from the parent, and it is possible to load any of the group's screen sets on a child API key by making an accounts.showScreenSetAPI call. While you can define multiple screen sets on the parent API key to cater to the different needs of each child site, the screen sets must conform to the same set of schema and policy settings that have been set for the entire site group. This concludes our tutorial of registration as a service for site grouping. Feel free to contact us if you have any questions or would like additional info.